Hey, I know you're busy and all, but I've got something I think you'll want to see. I'm still on Runic, but I relocated. Made some progress with our little project, and I needed a bigger setup. When you get a chance, come check it out. There's someone here who wants to meet you. Welcome to the new place. What do you think? Funny enough, most of it is thanks to the little Kiramud over there.
Clarification. Any contribution I have made to this fruitless endeavor has been entirely against my will.
Ah, don't listen to him. He's just trying to sound tough because we've got company. Had to make a few adjustments. It was getting way too hard to concentrate, always keeping one eye on him. But we're good now, right, Kiramud? Enough about him. Let's get to why you're really here. I'd like to introduce you to B3S1, Bessie. You know, after everything we've gone through to get here, it's good to hear you say that. Now, I know you might be thinking that she doesn't look like the other Basilisk you've run into. Kerr Harangir was doing some crazy experiments on this E-Cod, piecing all sorts of things together that didn't belong. Took a lot of work, but we finally got her into something that can move, something that can learn. Of course she learns. She's a Basilisk. Bessie's got all her basic functionality, but she still needs a lot of training before I can turn her over to you. Basilisk droids are more naturally adaptable than other droids. I can't just program her to do what you want. If we want her to remember how to be a Basilisk droid, we've got to teach her. She needs to learn by doing. So I'm thinking, if Bessie's going to be yours, you should be the one to take her out and train her. Hold on, we've still got a ways to go. But I love the enthusiasm. Take these. Training modules for Bessie. They'll help her focus on the things a Basilisk droid needs to know how to do.
Interjection. The Basilisk droid's learning capabilities are severely limited. The Mandalorian's training modules are woefully insufficient. Recommendation. Scrap the inferior Basilisk droid and put the parts to use elsewhere. Building a new chassis for yours truly, perhaps.
What about those memory chips you built for Bessie? Don't you want to see if they work?
Correction. I did not build these memory chips for the Basilisk droid. I simply required a distraction from the aggravating circumstances of my indentured servitude.
Whatever the reason, if anyone can get Bessie into shape, it's you. Nobody else has that kind of processing power.
Agreement. You are correct in your assessment, Mandalorian. You may demonstrate the usefulness of the memory chips to our visitor.
Puffing up that little ego of his is the only way I can get him to do anything. He got real agreeable once I started calling him Kiramud, killer. Most people don't bother listening to them. Once you do that, it's easy to get them to work with you. Those memory chips he built really are nothing to sneeze at. Bessie needs them to unlock behavioral programs I can't reach. Otherwise, she won't remember the things you teach her. Can't get her to do anything without a memory chip, if I'm being honest. If you want Bessie to work, make sure you give her one before you take her out. Only problem we haven't been able to work out is how long the memory chips keep the connection to her behavioral systems open. Keep an eye on how long you've got Bessie out there. I think that's everything. Why don't you get started? I'm sure Bessie's dying for some fresh air and exercise. Jate, can't wait to see what kind of data comes out of this.
Thank you. care.
How did it go?
Assessment. The Basilisk droid's capabilities are substandard. As I predicted, Mandalorian.
Yeah. Not like I didn't expect this. Bessie isn't going to be a full-fledged Basilisk after one day of training. Consistency is key. You have to keep at it. The more you train her, the more she's going to remember the Basilisk functionality that's buried in her memory core. Good. I'm not either. All the data you collected out there with Bessie will help me focus her learning abilities. Whatever you've got, put it in that terminal. I'll start combing through it.
Would you like to misuse my talents today? Request. Find another hobby.
What did I tell you? This data is just what I need. I know it sounds like a long shot, but if you keep bringing back this kind of research, Bessie will be everything we hoped in no time.
Interjection. No amount of field research will improve the chances of success for this hopeless project. Protestation. You dare equate an HK series assassin to this lumbering, unrefined Basilisk droid? Explanation. Without additional memory chips, it will never reach its full potential, inferior as it might be. Declaration. I will not waste processing power by building more.
Look here, Kiramud. You understand unfinished business? I'll take that as a yes. That's what this is. This is a big deal for me, for my people. I need to get Bessie working again. She's special. There's nothing like her in the whole galaxy. Kind of like you. What do you say? Can you make some more memory chips? Show Bessie she's worth saving?
Resignation? It seems I have no choice in the matter.
Knew you wouldn't let me down, Kiramud. Part of me doesn't care anymore. Even if no one else gives a damn. I'm not giving up on Bessie. It'll take the little Kiramud time to whip up more of those memory chips. Once he does, grab one from him and give it to Bessie. I'll work on some more training modules. You bring back any combat data you get while you're out there, and we can improve Bessie's functionality. We can do this. All of us. We just need to work together, yeah?